Monkeys!
Apes. Hey guys, Crew of Blind with, I'm Eric.
I'm Aaron.
And Aaron, we're going to watch a trailer for War
of the Apes!
For
Monkeys!
The Planet of the
Monkeys!
Apes. Aaron, what's the difference between monkeys and apes?
Some have fur.
No.
Bugs?
Nope. That's a different
tails.
Life form. Tails! There you go! What ones have what?
I don't know.
Okay. Aaron, have you seen any of the Rise of or...
I watched one with Franco in it.
James Franco. Tom Felton was in that one, too. He was like the shitty kid.
Really?
Like the jerk that kept like making fun of the monkeys.
That was him? He didn't have an accent.
Fucker, messed me up.
Monkeys, I got it!
I watched the second one thinking like, it's not a bad movie. And I got to what I thought was the end, and then I realized I had 20 more minutes, and the last 20 minutes were fucking awesome.
Really?
If you haven't seen that movie, go watch that movie. I had so much fun with it. So I guess I'm speaking to you. Go watch that movie.
Yeah, I want to go see it. I think I actually bought it on Blu-ray, but I haven't watched it yet. I need to have time when kids aren't around, probably,
because
I don't want them to be afraid of monkeys.
Now, we're going to watch this one, this trailer for the third one, but I would assume you might have a spoiler by watching this.
Oh, okay.
So I guess
Caesar. Is he in it?
Go!
Dude, horses.
They're on horses, yeah.
Dude, is this when they see the Statue of Liberty's head?
Nope.
That'd be cool. Is that Caesar?
Hey, he was in the first one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe not.
Did not start this war.
Is that Andy
Serkis? Yeah.
I offered you.
He can speak a lot better now.
Yeah. Ooh, that's a cool shot. I like the lights.
Is that Woody Harrelson?
I don't think so, was it? It could have been.
He had that look like he doesn't.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it's Woody Harrelson!
Has led to this moment.
Dude, that was that white one.
Irony
oh shit!
Created you.
Got the sun, probably.
And nature has been punishing us ever since. This is our last stand.
Wow!
Wow! No!
And if we lose,
monkey ran from that explosion.
Whoa!
Right with him?
It will be. A planet of apes.
War for the Planet of the Apes.
Wow. July 14th.
Okay.
That's 7 days after Spider-Man.
Oh, yeah, it is, isn't it? Well, hell. Dude, I gotta say, that orangutan is so realistic. Like, in the last movie, the second one, like, I kept looking at it, like paying attention, being like, I can't believe that's not a real orangutan. And then, I watched like the making of, completely CGI.
It looks really good.
I mean, we have awesome CGI these days. We have a lot of very talented artists, but there's still that separation in your head. Like, well, this isn't real.
Yeah.
This is. That's not real. That is. I can see the foreground elements. I can see the background. I can see the compositing. I can tell what's real and what's not.
Mm-hmm.
But that's one of the few times I ever looked at something and legitimately, like knowing it was CG, could not tell it was.
That's
awesome. That's how good it was.
I remember watching the behind-the-scenes stuff on the first movie and watching, like, they had, like, these extenders for their arms and stuff and, like their mocap and everything.
Yep.
They're, like, running through, like, the streets or over cars and stuff. And rah!
Yeah.
I was like, that looks so cool.
It was,
That'd probably be fun to do.
Yeah.
Like, pretend to be a monkey.
I'm pretty sure they have the movement coach from Lord of the Rings that, like, taught her, but, like, this is, if you're a dwarf, this is how you run. If you're an orc, this is how you run. Yeah. I think they did the same thing with these.
That's
now, Andy Serkis, he has that experience from, he actually did the motion capture for King Kong.
Oh, really?
Peter Jackson movie, so.
Okay.
He's already in the head of
it. He does motion capture for everything.
He's created an entire industry with it.
Yeah.
I mean, his risk, or Peter Jackson changed pretty much how motion capture is done because, you know, there was keyframe animation and then there was motion capture animation. Keyframe is just it's just animators animating.
Yep.
You know, obviously motion capture is capturing an actor. When they cast Andy to just do the voice, he would be on set and he would be acting with the, you know, with Elijah Wood and Sean Austin, you know? And when they were doing, like, you know, Frodo's scenes, like when the camera's pointing at Frodo, you know, he would be acting his heart out. But when they were doing Gollum scenes where they were going to be replacing him, they, you know, he could tell that Elijah Wood wasn't really giving it his all when it was his scenes. And he was like, dude, like, I'm an actor. I'm here. Like, work with me. You know, we want to be able to do the best we can. So when Peter Jackson saw that and he realized that in the scenes when Andy was actually physically there, Frodo would be so much better. But they would have to, you know, if they're doing animation, they have to cut him out. So they decided to do this mocap thing. Anyway, it all what happened was is Andy Serkis changed the fucking game. So, and he created his own production company that dealt with this. So now that's why he has consulted on the Avengers. That is why he is Snoke from Star Wars. Because if you want good motion capture, you have to go to Andy Serkis' company. And that's why he's getting all these fucking awesome roles, too.
Oh, jeez.
So, anyway, that was a long diatribe.
Yeah. Sorry. Well, I liked him as Caesar.
I loved him as Caesar.
I thought, I hated, like, I watching it and seeing, like, what happened with Caesar and everything, yeah. I felt so bad. Like, it was all just wanting to battle Alzheimer's, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And just...
Yeah.
And who was the dad?
John Lithgow.
Yeah. I felt so bad for him, too.
Dude, trust me, I mean, get a babysitter or something, because your kids don't... Probably wouldn't like it, but I mean, it is a good movie, and I, you know, I rarely give my recommendation out like that. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a great movie. I can't imagine you not loving it.
No, I'm sure I would.
And this looks good too.
Yeah, I think.
I love Woody Harrelson. Cool.
Yeah, I didn't know he was gonna be in it.
When I was like, who's that guy? He reminded me of Matthew McConaughey from the Dragon movie.
Yeah,
remember that? I saw his eyes, and I'm like, I remember seeing those eyes in True Detective. Okay.
He's just shaving his head.
Yeah. All right, that's going to be it, I guess.
Yeah.
The thing we'll take away from this is just look out for Woody Harrelson. You never know where he's going to pop up.
Yeah, or monkeys.
Thank you guys for checking out this video. If you would like to see more from Blind Wave, you hit the subscribe button. If you like this reaction, also please hit the like button. That helps us out.
Thank you.
There are buttons all over the place for videos and Patreon and a subscribe button. You have two chances to hit the subscribe button. You better fucking do it. Or there will be war.
Of monkeys.